privilege to have Mrs. Sanitha Gupta with me, principal of Air Force Bal Bharati School, New Delhi. Ma'am, you are the principal of one of the most prestigious academic institutions in New Delhi and India. Could you please describe your journey to reaching this tremendous position of responsibility and power?
Hi, Anya. It's a privilege to be interacting with you, and when you told me about this interaction, I thought about my journey of heading this prestigious institution, and it took me back to my college days. And after that, to begin with, I have done my graduation, BCom Honours, MCom, and BEd from Delhi University. And soon after that, as a young college pass out, I was looking for jobs, and I got traveled back into that time, and I was remembering, it feels like just yesterday, but it was 30 years back in 1990. I was sitting outside this office waiting for my turn for interview, and I was just hoping and pray that despite my lack of experience, the school considers me. And I was in awe with everything, looking around, and never in my wildest dreams did I imagine that one day I will be occupying the office next to the wall. Mm-hmm. So I thank God for that, for giving me the opportunity, for taking this responsibility, and that's it.
It's incredible hearing your experience of the interviews. So I'm sure you must have had many challenges in your journey. I'm curious about some of the challenges that you faced, and how did you overcome them, and what is your takeaway from them?
I won't call them challenges as such, but all working women, they do face, they have to balance, maintain work-life balance. And I was also required as a young mother, as a child, as a mother, I also have responsibilities, and over this journey, those responsibilities also needed to be taken care of along with my professional responsibilities. So, with the help of everybody around, I was able to manage it. Otherwise, it has been, smooth sailing.
How do you manage your personal and professional life?
I think God has given us capability to multitask. So it's not that we have to compartmentalize our lives, and we can take professional and personal lives. We can take care of both of them. And I keep telling myself I should switch on and off. When I'm at home, I should switch off school, and when I'm in school, I should switch off home. But usually what happens is I'm able to switch off home much easily, and but I'm not able to switch off school. Even if I'm at home, 100 things are going through my mind, and I'm working consciously or subconsciously for school 24/7. But with your support of your family and your colleagues, you are able to manage all this.
Definitely, it must have been very tough trying to find a balance between the two. Mm-hmm. So, what is your support structure?
My support structure is, of course, my family, my husband, my parents, my children, and my colleagues also. Because when you have worked for an institution for 30 years, then the line between family and colleague gets very faint. Your colleagues also become your family, and at the same time I'm resigning the campus, so my family also sort of has started working for the school. Okay. So that line has also got thin, and without this support structure I could not have got satisfaction of giving my best.
Wonderful. So in your interactions with young students, what difference do you see between the students of today and in the past?
Today, I will say that children are definitely very well informed. They are not limited by our knowledge. They are not limited by the knowledge of their parents or their teachers. They will find out information on their own thanks to computers, internet, and they are very resourceful, I'll say, not only in terms of technology, but also they have more as compared to our generation in terms of all kind of resources. They are not hypocrites. They speak their mind. I like that about them. They are more ambitious. They do not want to follow only their parents' footsteps. They want to do new things. If you talk about what they are missing is being hands-on. Because our generation, we were doing a lot at home. We were more hands-on. We were required to help our parents at home and we used to play a lot. So physical activity is missing for most of the children. There are exceptions always, but as far as technology, as far as knowledge, as far as confidence, they are really, really much ahead, light year ahead of us. They are very smart.
Those are really great insights. Particularly, what do you think of girls and what kind of progression have you seen throughout the years?
Gender equality and gender justice are two things that are very, very close to my heart. And in the school, we always ensure as a school that we do not encourage stereotypical roles for girls. So you would have seen that girls in our school are roaming around with cameras and they are playing footballs while boys are participating in baking competitions.
Yes.
So we try very hard to fight stereotypical roles, and it gives me a lot of pride and satisfaction that these days girls are progressing at a very fast pace. There is a little ground to catch up. I'm talking about metro cities, so here girls are reaching towards gender justice. In smaller towns and villages, I know that a lot more needs to be done. But if you look at IITs, if you look at engineering colleges, if you look at women pilot in Air Force, everywhere, lot of glass ceilings have been broken by girls. And now when I look at the girls in the school, they are not bothered about what other people think about them. They have their own goals, they speak their mind, and they make it very clear that they will live life on their own terms. And we wouldn't want it any other way.
That's great. And being a proud student of AFBBS, I really thank you for creating such an equal and free environment for girls in this school.
So that Thanks. Is my pleasure.
Any particular case of you mentoring any student to overcome obstacles?
See, our school, Air Force Bal Bharati, is a melting pot. It has children from all walks of life. So we take a great pride that we have grandchildren of president, we have bureaucrat children, Air Force children, industrialist children. They are along with children from the first generation learners. That way you find all kind of students in the school, and sometimes I do feel the children coming from humble background, they are hesitant to speak, they are hesitant to mix up with the other children because they have this complex. So for these children, I have counseled few children telling them that in this country where the Prime Minister had such a humble beginning, what do you have to be ashamed of or scared of? So don't be ashamed of your background, and you should take pride in being able to come up so well. And unless you are proud of your own achievements, of your own background, nobody else will. So that way I saw that few children who earlier were very, very withdrawn in their shell, they came out and they realized that unless they are confident about themselves, they will not get a fair deal. So that has given us a lot of satisfaction.
Beautifully said. So what is your message or guidance to the young generation?
To the young generation, one thing which I forgot to mention earlier was that they are very compassionate. Okay. They want to do a lot for the society. So I would say to young generation that if you are honest, if you are disciplined, and if you have compassion, then nothing can stop you from being happy and successful. Only professional success does not matter much. beyond a point, you realize that it does not make you feel happy. So unless you have that happiness of giving, that basket is not complete. One should be able to give and take both. So that compassion, along with integrity, along with discipline, will take you a long way.
That was such great advice, and I'm sure that all the young people who are watching this video would have great takeaways from it. Finally, what is your message to the Her Success Bits community and our viewers?
Anya, what you're doing is fantastic.
Thank you so much,
ma'am. I can't tell you how proud I am of you taking this initiative, and that's what, when I look at you, I know that girls of this country can never lag behind. And you know, I am a little biased towards girls because I, you know, in my interaction, I always find that usually I find girls are more devoted, dedicated, more committed than boys. So I wish you all the success, and please continue with this good work.
Thank you so very much, ma'am, and I feel honored to have the opportunity to speak with you. So yes, hersuccessfits.com, write, inspire, empower.